Hola, hola, aquí estamos de regreso otra vez, regresando de vacaciones. Fuimos a Oaxaca. Yo creo que sí vieron en el YouTube los restaurantes en Oaxaca, delicioso. Hi everybody, we just came back from vacation from Oaxaca. I hope you enjoy my videos of the restaurants over there. The food is delicious. So today I'm gonna cook some salmon with one of the moles I brought from Oaxaca. This is the coloradito mole. So I'm gonna cook the salmon regular in the oven. And the sauce, the paste, I'm gonna put it with chicken broth. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cook some beans, black beans, with onion and a little bit of garlic. Put it on top of the salmon and then put it in the oven. And once it's ready, we're going to add the sauce, the mole, coloradito. And we're gonna also make some rice. We're gonna accompany it with rice and some zucchini. The Mexican zucchini and the Italian zucchini. I think we call it in Italian. Got two kids that we're gonna cook with onion and pepper and salt. Okay, I already make the rice. The rice I can make it in 10. It's empty. The rice I can make it in like 5 minutes. And we just let it cook. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the paste that I bought in Oaxaca. For the mole, and the name of this mole is coloradito. Okay, I'm gonna put it here. And see how easy it is, like a paste. And what we're gonna do is we take all the paste from the back, and then we're going to add some of the chicken broth. You add as much as you want. Depends how liquid you want it or how thick. First I'm gonna put only one and then I'm gonna stir it. One can. For, I think this is 1 kilo. No, 1/2 kilo of the paste. And do it with a low fire, because if you do it too high, it start boiling and then you can burn. So, and we're gonna, once it's really, really, really mixed, you're going to prepare the salmon. Okay. And leave. Pero antes de meterlo al horno, vamos a preparar lo que le voy a poner arriba al salmón. ¿Dónde está la tapa? Acá. Aquí está la tapa de este. Entonces, así lo ponemos a fuego lento y que se quede ahí. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna chop 1/2 onion. Okay. Chop the onion in the maravilloso. So you don't have to spend too much time. I love this machine. Chop the onion and put the pan and put some olive oil. This is for fry a little bit the onion. And then we're gonna put the black beans on top. Okay, inside. But first let's chop. Ok, ponemos a dorar la cebolla. Había pensado en rajitas, pero no así picadas también. Ponemos a dorar la cebolla. Mientras, abrimos. Hoy no tuve tiempo de guisar frijoles porque no había pensado ponerle el frijol negro, pero siempre es bueno tener una latita. ¡Ay! Estos no son de bola. Tiene que ser de bola. Ok, once the onion is already a little bit brown, we're going to add the black beans, but it has to be the bean, not much beans. We're gonna drain it and drain it so it doesn't stain all the and you're gonna put it in on top of the onion that is already. I think two will be fine. One is too much. I'm gonna put a lot. Okay. And we can put a little bit garlic if you want. The garlic that is already minced, not too much. Once it's everything, you mix it. So the beans get a little bit also cooked. They are cooked already, eh? Don't put raw beans. Aquí tenemos el salmón entero. Lo vamos así. Hay que partirlo en trozos medianones. Para eso pueden usar las tijeras. You can use the scissors to cut it. I think pieces like this, and then half. Will be fine. Le vamos a poner, okay, sal, pimienta y aceite de oliva. Ay, tenemos que prender el horno en 340. 340 de oven. Ok, vamos a ponerle sal, pimienta, va a quedar riquísimo. You put salt and pepper and a little bit of oil in all the pieces. And let's make it all. And what we're gonna do is, you're gonna grab the beans with the onion already cooked, and you're gonna put it on top. And I'll show you. You can see, you put it on top of the salmon. Okay, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna cover it and cook it only 12 minutes in 340. Okay, let me share with you that I'm drinking a little mezcal in these beautiful glasses that they call, it's the same way they made the alebrijes. It's wood painted by hand, and with some warm salt and the crickets. Not crickets, they're called chapulines in Oaxaca. They're so good, it has a lot of protein. They are delicious. They are with lemon and chili, and we have with garlic and all type of different ones. So, the way you drink the mezcal is with the salt, lemon salt, and the little cricket. It's a delicatessen. It's delicious. We're gonna cut the zucchini in little squares because we're gonna cook it with onion and garlic in my pot. Okay. Put oil on the pan. And what we're going to do is we are cutting the zucchini in four, two, half, and then half and of the half. And then in little squares. And this one you don't put it in the maravillosa because it's gonna be like rice, like this. You don't have to. But we're gonna let the zucchini cook a little bit. And then we add the onion. Here it. You can put some paprika. Salt. And pepper, okay? I find the pepper. And then what you're going to do is mix it. And see, when it's a little bit cooked, almost all the zucchini, you add the onion. And let it cook for like 5 minutes. And not too high, 5. Right now the oven is already 340, and I'm gonna put the salmon over there. Okay. Once we're almost done, the fish is already in the oven at 340 for 12 minutes. Okay. And the zucchini is almost done. The rice is done, beautiful. And the mole coloradillo is warm already. Okay. Once everything is ready, I serve the plate and I'm going to. This is how it looks: the rice, the zucchini, and the salmon covered with mole and some queso fresco on top. Enjoy it. It's delicious. A ver, ay, Andy. How is it? How is this mole?
Not as good as yours, but very good. Yeah. A little spicy.
It's a little spicy.
What's good?
It's chile rojillo, okay. Very good. I love it. Bueno, see you.